Yo, what is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today we are at the 2024 Bonny Eagle Car Show. We are out here representing with the black truck because purple truck is down. But figure we get this thing up in the show, hang out, and go check out what's here. Mr. Tofu Driver rolling in. What's up, G?
I just slid up on the grass like last year.
Bro, that's actually so funny because you had the multicolor 86 and I had the purple truck. My other truck's down, so we got this thing. Look at this, Endless showing up hard as hell this year. Sheesh. Bro, just made his own parking. So what better way to start off the video than with Brendan's beautiful Toyota SW20 MR2. This thing is the Japanese model, so the steering wheel is on the right-hand side. Over on some Volk TE37, some beautiful accents all around this car. We'll definitely do a deeper dive into it later on. But he does have his own channel, so go check that out. That is JDM SW20. And right on this side, there's a little Mini Cooper, and something interesting is actually this whole hood is carbon fiber, which is sick. But these have got to be the smallest carbon fiber fenders I've ever seen. I mean, they are just tiny. It pretty much just covers up to there. Just thought that was interesting. Got some of the older Nissans over here. This is Carrie's 180SX. So in America, we didn't get the 180. We got the 240. If it has the steering wheel on the right-hand side and it's from Japan, it's the 180. And if it's from Europe, it's the 200SX. But this is SR20 DET powered, all wide-bodied. This is like probably my favorite rear end of a car. This thing is just amazing. The cannon back here, all cleaned up. And right next to it is Travis's Nissan 300ZX, the Z32. It's been a really long time since we've seen this on the channel. He's got the F40 spoiler. It is painted in the, I believe it's a Skyline. It's a factory Nissan color, the Millennium Jade. So in certain parts of the sun, you see it. It is gold, and then it goes to like a dark green. So that's pretty nasty to see it all together now. And as I was talking to him, he's just got a bunch of plans for it. And just cool to see cars like this together, because these were huge back in the 90s. So this makes for a pretty cool clip. Right over here is what I thought was an IS350, but it's actually an IS500. So with the 500 being a bigger engine, you get a bigger brake setup right here. These wheels are really, really clean color to go with this beautiful blue. It is the four-door, which is really cool to see, like I said, with the 500 engine. And right over here is a Lexus ISF. So this is the coupe. It's got the V8 500 in it. And I just didn't know that they made an IS500. I thought they only made the 350. That's what I thought the four-door was. So that is just cool to see. Obviously, completely different body-styled cars, but I just wanted to throw that in there. I thought it was really interesting. Right over here is a, I believe, Evo 8, maybe 9. I think it's a 9. I could be wrong. Just cool to see. Love seeing these cars. All-wheel drive, turboed. Look at that intercooler hanging out down there. Pretty cool Mercedes. Got a really, really nice wrap on there. Color-changing pearlescent with the blue, the purplish red. It's unique. John's bagged Accord. We got Ramey's 4C. Don's bagged Ranger. Right over here is Sean's Lexus GS350. Kevin's 240SX with the Sylvia nose swap. Big side skirts. We got Isaiah's Acura Integra. Nice carbon fiber wing down here. All black interior. Got a full length vid on this car. Definitely go check that out. Cody's AE86 with the 4AGE chilling down there. In love with these cars as well. I love their check. I like how they got the matching checkered floor mats. The black truck. We got the Harlequin. This is a Volkswagen. Back in the day, they released a Harlequin paint scheme on cars. And, well, this guy has reiterated that on a newer model Volkswagen. And funny enough, he has the plate colorblind. Obviously, the car is multicolored, but he actually is colorblind, which is pretty funny. So all kind of ties in. It is on bags. These wheels are incredible as well. I don't know what this is just yet. It is a it's a Toyota. It's a Celica. Wow, I didn't even realize. Powered by the 20R. Nice E. So it's a single overhead. This is cool though. Like a completely untouched Celica. I don't know. Maybe. I don't think I've seen one of these. That was cool, man. Kind of caught me off guard. I like all the old trim, how it all kind of sits in there. And I believe it's probably carbureted by the way that's set up. That's awesome. It's a 1980. Had to grab a clip. This is so similar to my little brother's 86 Monte Carlo. It's 86 or 87, whatever it is. I love the little cowl hood. My brother needs that. But check out these American Racing wheels. They're a little bigger, less tire than what my brother has. But, oh man, I like that style so much more. That looks fantastic. Yeah, this is an 87 by the taillights. Look how good those look. Stop by the flipping customized booth. We're going to go check out some of his cars later. He's got a Project Freight Train back there. But we just picked up this super sick Nissan Hardbody key rack, which is so sick. He's like, oh, I had you in mind when I was making this. So go check him out. Well, right over here, Lex's truck is parked over in the diesels class. Her big, beautiful four-door long bed F-350. She got my roof back here, but don't tell no one that. So, okay, it looks like there's some sort of vans class today. And I love seeing the Mitsubishi. I think they're the Delicas. That's awesome. Like, these are two different ones, actually. Super unique. The lights on the front, the bars on the front. Kind of cab over style. Obviously, both right-hand drive because these are straight from Japan. Oh, that's... I wonder why the seat flips up. Must be to get to the engine. That's a sexy truck. Yeah, right to get to the engine. Your passenger seat flips up. Get all this extra room in here. I love the green color scheme on this, though. Ladder to get up at the top. Our state's making it harder and harder to register these out here, but it's awesome seeing them. We got this GMC Sierra. Regular cab, short bed, square body. Looks like we got a nice LS in there. Love the wheel lights on this. The silver is beautiful. Oh, check out that four link, man. Nice patinaed bed. The whole outside of the truck is painted right up beautifully. This is another very crazy truck as well, though. This is a bagged, bodied, raised floor bed with all the red accents. Check out this interior, all red in there. Amp set up so perfectly fit in there as well on the back cab wall. This is like, I love this. Look at the size of these wheels. Then we have Vito's square body S10. I always love the little model of his truck. Purple valve covers. And one of the craziest things, how wide his wheels are, man. This thing is set up for going down the track 100%. So it's awesome to see it going down the street. We got the square body Blazer with the vet wheels. These fit amazingly well on the Blazer. Nice little lower down Tahoe. I have not seen this one around before. I love the blue on blue. And then, ooh, clear taillights too. I've never seen clear taillights on these, and I love it. We are big on the clears. And we got Dan's big Ford F-150. It's the four-door short bed on these insanely massive wheels. So I'm excited to see this out here laid right on the ground. We're hanging out with Dan, and we got one of the honorary friendship wheel pieces. Yep. Said his wheel exploded on the highway. And this new barrel looks fresh, though, but definitely unfortunate. But look at that chunk of wheel. It's like that whistle and diesel when he grounded up the...
That's so funny.
Put them in jars. Give them out for Christmas. Pretty neat to see. This is the truck that's slowly coming back from the 90s. It was a bit of a survivor. It's getting some work done. It's cleaning up real nice. Got that beautiful paint scheme down the side. Little roll pan back here. It's got the old Corvette taillight style. That was a huge thing back in the day. But I always like seeing the progress of this truck as he continues to revive it. I'll check this thing out. Little step side C10 on the ground. This thing looks polished. It looks bodied as well. LS in here, gorgeous truck. Raised wood floor bed. Wow, that is cool. This is a very unique class. We got a 56 Studebaker pickup. Nice and round. You don't see too many of the old Studebaker pickups like this. And most importantly, next to this lifted square body Chevy is this, looks to be all original Datsun 620. Man, it's been a minute since I've seen a nice 620. This is very clean. I mean, these trucks didn't really, unfortunately, didn't really last out here because of, you know, the salt. So I love it. That's pretty sweet. I think it's a 63 Impala. That's dope. I was gonna say, I heard hydraulics. We know that sound. Yes, sir. Oh, you know we love to see it. Boys, I don't even know what this is, but we're going to walk around it. It says, just says HMV, high mileage vehicle. That's all it says. It's interesting. Minnesota. Oh, it's literally called a HMV? That's so funny. Yeah, I was like, I don't know. Wow. That's very cool. It's super unique. Is it? I would say it must be classified as a motorcycle.
No, yeah. It's an autocycle.
Oh, autocycle.
Yes, they changed the law in
2019. Wow, because of the slingshots? Wow.
It doesn't look like your typical Z engine, huh?
Well, that's because it's not. It's a turbo LS. It's very unique style turbo, too. I mean, it comes right up to the front bumper. The air intake's sitting there. This is fancy. I like it. Big intercooler peeking out of the bottom of that bumper. Carbon fiber fenders, carbon fiber hood. That's pretty nasty. Probably woke this car right up. I love the paint on this 57. It starts out with the red nose, kind of fades into some purple flames. That is very awesome to see. Yeah, that's a pretty serious rig. Full off-road build out of like an old Dodge truck. Oh, and the engine is rear mounted. That's awesome. This whole setup is kind of crazy. Like the transfer, it must be the transfer case right there in the center. These are pretty serious axles too. Man, that is wild. This is for sure my cup of tea. Rat Rod. Hey, there's Peter. This is just the man I wanted to see looking at something like this. He is our custom guy down here for sure. Dude, this is awesome. Right on the ground. Beautiful chop. Like, so well done. I don't know if the plan is to keep it like this or it's a Pontiac. 1948 Pontiac. Or if he's just kind of in the midst of restoration. I mean, these wheels kind of give me that. These are like the style wheels you usually use on these kind of patinaed builds, but this is cool. So this is probably gonna be my favorite vehicle that has showed up today. I was standing back here and I was like, okay, this is beautiful, you know, nice little wide fitment back there. And next thing you know, I look over and it has an RB25 in here. Absolutely gorgeous. Nice little walk around on this. It's cool too though, because it's not the typical coupe style. This one is a little bit bigger, so it must be like the 4+4 or whatever they would call them back in the day. This is the most gorgeous car here. Most definitely. With that RB in there, I mean, this thing must just get down. And this is a 280Z. They're actually both 280Zs. Little 5-speed manual. That's cool. There's a badge for it on the back of this. That Z emblem. Still got the stock, whatever L28 it would be. But, wow, that RB is fantastic. That is so wild to see in there. Beautiful LS swap Chevy Nova rolling through right now. Listen to that thing chop. I don't know, this is pretty cool. There's a lot of really nasty cars here I didn't get to film, but little cab over Ford pickup. Oh man, the engine's back here. That is so sick. Dude, that's like 10 times cooler seeing that setup. These BRZs be sounding a little funny these days. Get a little lowrider clips for y'all. Yes, sir. Had to grab a clip of the two 280s leaving as well. Those are so sweet. We got the yellow 280 and then the RB1. Beautiful. Beautiful set of cars. That thing is phenomenal. Listen to this thing. Damn. There goes Dan and his Mr. 2. I wish I got to get a little bit more of these cars coming through here. It was just like impossible to catch everything. Beautiful Nova though. This Challenger is very, very nice too, especially in that purple. Hobbs 55 Chevrolet Bel Air Gasser with the Cadillac 500 in it. Beautiful car to see. Hey. Good to see ya. There goes the Dodge Dart. Ah, this is just as fun. I gotta say real quick, we got Lexus pulling in. this has got to be one of the most beautiful Corvairs I have ever seen. I don't know, it just looks great. Here comes Lexus. Mustang. Oh, this is the Mustang California Special. So this has like the Shelby taillights. It's a factory custom Mustang. I mean, that is very, very unique. I actually wish I was able to get a little bit more of an up-close video on that beautiful red street rod right here. Little two-door 64 Impala. That's so beautiful. Oh, it's the Bel Air. That's beautiful. I believe this is a 64, though. Yeah, it definitely is. Little 86 Elko. I can't wait to see that buggy come through here. That's cool. A little purple old Ford pickup coming through. Giving y'all some commentary, like just walking around, seeing what comes through. There goes the Bel Air. Oh man, this is nasty. Oldsmobile, that's cool. Especially this thing too, man. Wow. Twin turbo, I don't know what it is from here. That's nasty. That's so sick too. The GTO, that's a nice car. That is badass. We got the Woody's panel, man. That's cool. Evan's little blue Miata rolling through. And a couple other cool cars coming through. We're gonna walk back over to the truck now. I just wanted to get some of those coming in and out for y'all. Wow, look at this 6 Camaro. Actually, this is a 68, I believe. Ooh, nice car, man. And the Chevelle. Grab a clip of this beautiful GT500 Shelby before we head out of here. Love the exhaust tips on these. Honestly, my favorite taillights, my favorite nose. Had to grab a quick walk around. Look at it go. That is awesome. That is too cool. Well, everybody, it's soaking wet now. We are chilling here. We got the flat truck over here. I got the roof and Lexus truck, so I'm going to slap that on there. But we're going to head home. That is the quick vid of the 2024 Bonny Eagle car show. A lot of lowered trucks, some of the tuners. I tried to squeeze in some muscle cars, but honestly, we were just spending too much time hanging out with everybody. If you want to see some more car content in the future, don't forget to like and subscribe. Peace out.